And from the president, the leadership of CITU, the leadership of Ferdinand Nene. For the period of 2 days, you have listened attentively and you have listened to the struggles that you deliberate on. Today, you have an opportunity to listen to the challenges that affect you as workers and affecting your country. You also listen and have the privilege to listen to the class discussion and class problems and class challenges. But you are also heartened by the fact that your country has now want to turn to fascism. Your country has now want to turn to use religion, racism of different kind. This is not new. To us, we are not surprised because these are challenges that we have met in the world. As a World Federation of Trade Union, we are pleased to listen to your problem and we are pleased to be together with you in the struggle. It is so because in the inception of this oldest federation in the world, you were at the forefront of creation of this federation. Even at the time that Prophets of Doom felt that WFGU must die, the Indian and Indian community and the Indian working class refused. It is also important and an absolute pleasure to us to be together with you in solidarity. When you raise your issues, when you march on roads, when you confront your government, but at the most, when you confront the enemy of the working class and its tactics, the tactics of capitalism, the capitalism that is campaigned by fascism, the capitalism that is campaigned by imperialism. You are a classical example of working class resistance. You are a classical example of working class fighting. You have been in forefront of this struggle. Hence, you are not surprised in one of your pictures to see one of your heroes and one of your struggle icons. Among them is a friend of the working class in Africa, a friend of working class in the world, Comrade Sugarman Sen. We have experience and learn how to approach the struggle of the working class from you. We have gained an experience and talk about it and empower other workers in the world and always say to them, look to the working class of India. You are one of the important section of our society, in our class. We are one of the important countries that when we deal with the struggles of the working class in the world, we are amongst the countries that we say, as long as the working class in India is still organized, the struggle to defeat the capitalism and fascism is possible. Comrade, the 97-200 million working class in the world has engaged in different struggles, different levels, and different countries. The period in which we've existed in the WFGU of 75 is going to be recognized in Paris in March in the Presidential Council. In this symmetry, we will doing the account of things and struggle and failure and success and strengthen the World Federation of Trade Union in different areas. We seem to be challenged when it comes to the struggle for youth. We seem to be challenged when it comes to the struggle for women. The most society today that is most oppressed and double oppressed amongst the working class and some of our sectors is women. This is going to be one of the struggles that WFGU wants to exist and proceed with our struggle. We must win. In any society that it describes itself as Marxist and it wants to measure its struggle, it must make sure that the working class and the struggle of the working class women is one of the forefront of this struggle. It must be a priority. One of the revolutionaries in the African continent, Comrade Samora Machel, said, if you want to liberate the society, you must liberate women. This comrade is important because it begins to sensitize our different sector, our different level, and it sharpens our political consciousness and sharpens our political classes. You must know one thing, that in a class struggle, no one else that's going to fight with you, that in class struggle, no one else that's going to be together with you, that in class struggle, it is you and your class counterpart, it is you and your class comrade, it is you and the workers of the world that must unite, that they must become together. And it is important that time to time, we must pledge solidarity into the class in the, all over the world. Who are our eminent enemies? Who are the people that are threatening the working class sovereignty? What is taking place in the world today? We want to point out to you, without a doubt, that you must open your eyes, that the Third World War that has been followed by the Second World War that has been coming the result of the existence of WFGU is imminent. The Third World War is imminent and it's going to come from America. The Third World War is imminent and it's going to come because people are fighting with resources. The Third World War is going to come, and when it takes place, the most people that are going to suffer in the process of its existence is women. And the most people that are going to suffer in the process of this taking place is the working class. Those uniformed men that you call in soldiers are your children. Those uniformed women that you call in soldiers are your children. And they're going to die not because they're fighting for their own cause, not because they're fighting for the interest of the capitalist class and its own profit. You must resist it. Working class in the world must come together and say to Donald Trump, and to say to Britain, and say to the friends of imperialists that not in our name, that we are going to create war in order to destroy our own countries. India is organized. India, working class exists. In India, the working class needs to be united and have one common program. And that program is must be opposed the Third World War. That program must be opposed the imminent and the signs in which capitalism seems to be desperate. India must contribute to that struggle. India must do everything in its power to say, firstly, we are not going to allow you to divide us as a society. We are not going to allow laws that are going to divide us. And furthermore, we are not going to allow you to use our taxes and to use our people in order to contribute into the senseless law. Whoa. When we come to the unemployment of working class in the country, in the society, if you put together the numbers, you come close to the 4.4 billion of people unemployed all over the world. When you come to those percentages and you put them together, the most prominent number of those people who are unemployed are women and youth. This means, comrade, that our struggle must respond to this challenge. Our struggle must talk to this challenge, and each and every country must begin to raise sharply that these issues are of a problem of the world. We want to call upon to the working class organization. We want to call upon to the communists of the world. We want to call upon to those who are calling themselves masters of the world and say today that when Lenin said and asked questions, what must be done, if that question becomes relevant now in the world, and all of us must ask the question, what must be done? We call upon the communist party of the world to come together in one conference and discuss the relevant and the problems and the challenges of today and come to a solution as communists all over the world. And we must, because if we do, we are going to recognize that from before, from beginning, from today, we now have realized and it has proven that capitalism was never a solution, can never be a solution. Well, I want to speak about the African continent and say to you, that continent needs a help. And the help of that continent is not going to come from capitalists. The help of that continent must come to the working class of the world to help that continent. The simplest thing we need to do, we must organize African continent and organize working class in the African continent and make sure that working class in the African continent speak exactly the same language. Here's a problem, comrades. We have people who are calling themselves unions. We have people who are calling themselves federations. But the mere fact that they are collaborators, that they are collaborating with the enemy of the working class, they don't deserve and they can never be qualified a working class organization. They use euros. They use dollars. They do everything to buy people wherever they go. They promise people a bright future because they bribe them. We must not do the same. We must not bribe people. We must not bribe working class so that we can cooperate with capitalists. We must conscientize. We must train the working class. We must conquer the consciousness and ideological of the working class itself, so that working class can understand their responsibility and what is it that they're supposed to do in order to make sure that they free themselves from the bondage of capitalism. Imperialists, they don't have your interests. They are not interested in you. They don't want you. They don't love you. They love your country. They love the resources of your country. They want to exploit you. They want to make profit out of you. They want to squeeze your blood so that they can make profit out of you. You must say no. Colonel Gaddafi told the people of Libya why America pretend as if they love him. Colonel Gaddafi tells the the people of Libya, that I, as Gaddafi, I will die in this country, I will never go to exile. But you must know that they don't love you, they love your oil, they love your land, they don't want you. Since that time, as a stable country as it was, today is a country of wars. When Saddam was in his country, that country was stable. Today is a country of war. Everywhere when America goes, countries are left unstable. They went to Syria. Syria would be destroyed today if it was not because of the intervention of Russia. Now we must ask questions. How many times is Russia going to intervene in opposition to America? And where does that lead us? The answer is clear. That's leading us into the Third World War. Evidently, almost, that America nearly clashed with China on basis of trade and rights. Today, many people are dead, crushed from aeroplane, because the army of Iran made a mistake, and without them knowing that this is deliberate, because America, look, they are looking for friends, and they want to make sure that one day the resources of that country belong to them. We must say no. We must say no from our government, from cooperating with America. We must say no because in an America is an agenda. But in doing that, we must make sure that we organize the working class in America, because the working class in America is not the problem. The problem is the government of the United States of America and its police. So, in March, in our presidential council, we will discuss this problem. We will discuss the things that we think that needs to be done. And hopefully, and we know that the country will be present. In after that discussion, we will have programs that will tend to deal with these issues and go to different continents and make sure that we succeed. The request from us to you, workers of India, the request from us to you, the working class of India, is that you must please continue the struggle, must please continue the talks of the working class, and you must please continue to campaign, and you must please continue to apply solidarity amongst you and apply solidarity all over the world. Thank you very much.